How's it going, YouTube? It's your boy Ron, and welcome back to our final episode of our Pokemon Stadium 2 walkthrough series. In the last episode, we had gotten our Prime Cup in one of our greatest battles. It is certainly one of the most difficult cups, and even with our own team, we still managed to do quite well. And of course, we wrapped up the entire stadium. We are nearly entirely done with the game. Our last opponent is going to be our rival for round 2. He is what's preventing us from completing the entirety of the game, thus being the final episode and our final battle with him. We are going to go ahead and get him one-on-one again like we did in round 1. And at the end, I will go ahead and wrap up the series and go ahead and explain a little bit more on what I'm going to be planning on doing and what's to see of the whole channel so far. But one step at a time, let's start off with going ahead and facing our rival because he is our last hurdle. And since he is going to be bringing level 100s, I could bring my team, but of course a similar strat that many people do, and I am going to do myself, is going to go ahead and bring along a team that is going to be more suited to handle this task. That's going to be, let me make sure I can remember the pokes, because I will admit I sometimes forget. I keep forgetting them, I will be honest. I'm always gonna just forget. There's really another one I could bring, I just can't remember. I always forget this lineup. Who am I forgetting? There's someone I'm forgetting. I'm probably gonna end up hurting myself for this later, but you know what, just gonna go with this. So I'm gonna go ahead with this team, I'm just not gonna bother bringing items. We're gonna be doing a similar strat that we did in round 1. Of course, the difference for round 2 with the rival is that while he still maintains the same 3 Pokemon, their stats are jacked to the max and their movesets are even deadlier. Yo, you're finally got here. I will decide things once and for all. And there we go, he still brings all the 3 legendary staples. And I'm gonna hope I'm predicting this right. I really do, so I'm just gonna go ahead with this team.
This is a match against the challenger's rival. Let's hope we see some polished techniques in the battle against this long.
Pretty anticlimactic, but of course our final battle is not exactly one of the greatest, but is meant to be, of course, the toughest of all. Since our rival is, of course, our rival, he is, of course, bringing the one Pokemon that is supposedly nasty to deal with. Which, in this sense, is true being all legendaries. But, of course, we're going to pretty much copy the entire strat. He should go ahead and attack first. As long as I don't see a crit right off the bat.
Wow! Drill the weakness! Battle? Oh, it's Ho-Oh! The opponent is weak. What an opportunity!
Alright, going well. I'm gonna get outspent anyway, so.
A blast of sacred fire! Right, that's a hit! Yes, he's going down! There's a big difference.
I need to save Voltorb. I forget. I'm gonna go ahead with Wobbuffet. I really don't remember what it is, to be honest.
Oh, it's Wobbuffet!
I'm gonna just hope this is a good call. But it is gonna go safeguard, so I'm just gonna do the same thing of safeguard. Oh, I guessed that completely wrong.
What's that? A light hit.
Well, I probably was gonna do Mirror Coat, so I'm gonna.
He shrouded himself with safeguard.
Try Miracle again.
White hot battle.
I'm gonna try Miracle and see if it does. Alright, land. Just land. I hope it doesn't knock it out at 381.
There's the attack! That inflicted some damage.
That did about a little under 200.
Miracle!
So it's still gonna leave it with a little bit of HP. Yeah. Alright, and then this one will knock me out.
This is the attack!
starting to look good. I'm actually going to bring Aaron back. And I still want to say Baltimore would find Kobe in game 2.
Oh, it's Aaron. Bone is weak. Now is the time to attack. The commands are made. A show on ancient power.
And for pretty much using our entire, our own team for the entirety of the run, except in obvious cups, our final battle is with Rental, not our own team. Go figure. I really don't have anything good, so I'm just gonna go ahead and just fight.
Pokemon type. Wow! Wonderful! There's a big difference in the number of Pokemon remaining on each side.
Yeah, Voltorb. I'm just
going to
play safe. It's going to be supposed to use Psychic, and it shouldn't knock it out. It should not.
The Safeguard wore off. The number of remaining Pokemon is 3-1.
All right, as long as it doesn't crit. It just doesn't. Ah! It just can't crit.
What now? A crushing blow! There are no more remaining Pokemon! And there goes the battle!
Are you happy that you won? Sure, go ahead and brag about it. Okay, and that clears our rival for round 2, and then thus... with very poor quality graphics that we'll see in just a moment, that gives us the credits again. Roll the credits, because that means we are now 100% done with Pokemon Stadium 2. We've completed every battle that we can. Of course, there's also like classroom, and those playing minigames doesn't really count towards the completion of the game. It's just the stadiums and Gym Leader Castle, which we've done all in its entirety. And man, oh, what a great run it's been. With using my own team, of course, it's made things easier, obviously. Round 1, apart from really a couple battles, most notably I can think of off the top of my head was our first notable loss at Team Rocket. It was really just some bad luck on that battle that caused us to lose our very first match here. But in terms of Gym Leader Castle as an entirety, it wasn't that bad. For round 1, it was what you expect to be pretty easy. Greatest battle from the 8 gym leaders, though, had to have been Chuck. For those who haven't watched it, please do. That was such a great 2 battles. His first, I believe, is Ty, the Black Guy, I think that's his name. He nearly wiped out my team with Orgill. Luckily, Smoochum came in clutch, because that was about to be our first loss right there, but Smoochum came in beautifully. And then with Chuck, oh my god, my luck almost ran out there too. Nearly lost. I don't remember how it went down, but we did get our win through a very close call. That was one of the greatest battles that we've seen in the beginning. Elite Four was good. No troubles there. We were able to do it one try with our own team, of course. And Lance was good. When we went to Kanto, everything was pretty good in Kanto as well. Lieutenant Surge gave us our loss there due to some very bad luck. Porygon ruined our strat and knocked out Dugtrio with a crit. That didn't help. We could have won that easily if it weren't for that. Our first loss in Kanto there. In terms of Gym Leader Castle as a whole, though, it was what you expect with your own team. Pretty self-explanatory and not too difficult. Then we had moved on to the stadium. Let me see, I can't think of anything too particularly bad at the moment. Little Cup was perfect. Really no trouble there. Poke Cup Stadium, Pokeball was amazing, and that was an amazing end if you guys hadn't seen that. Final battle, all I had was Kadabra, needed a crit, and we landed it. That was about to be our first loss in the stadium, and in a sad twist of events, a loss at Poke Cup, Pokeball. Would have been pretty sad, but our luck was necessary there, because that was a great way to end it. Then the rest of the run was pretty good. Challenge Cup was perfect. I believe was perfect as well. We didn't get exactly the greatest teams there either, but we still did get there. And then Prime Cup was the last one, and Prime Cup for round one was pretty, I don't want to say easy, but it was pretty straightforward, especially with your own team that wasn't that difficult. So in its entirety, round one, while handing us maybe like a total of two or three losses in total, was still overall an easy cup, overall an easy round, probably like a 9 out of 10 in terms of difficulty, of course 10 being easy and 1 out of 10 being not that difficult at all, like, I can't talk, it was just very low in difficulty. And then we moved on to round 2, and then that's where we started to see, of course, a lot of the difficulty increases there, although Gym Leader Castle in Johto for round 2 was still pretty good. I don't remember when we got our loss. I just know a lot of our battles were close and not that straightforward just because of the mixture of teams, and we just needed a lot of luck in some areas. So I think overall Gym Leader Castle in Johto was pretty straightforward too. The Elite Four brought us our issue though. We did have to restart that one. It was a bad Karen fight in the beginning. Very unlucky. It was very, very unlucky. But our second time around we did win, and then we got very fortunate with lands. That was perfect too. Then after that we had moved on to Kanto, and Kanto for round 2 was a little bit trickier. Misty was an annoying fight, and Lieutenant Church was a very annoying fight. Brock was easy, but that took a long time. It was a very long battle for those who saw it, or want to go ahead and check it out so you can at least see what that was all about. Pretty much after Lieutenant Surge, everyone up until Blue was pretty easy, honestly. I guess we just got lucky with the teams and the selection that we picked. So that was simple for us. Blue was a little bit more tricky. Red, our final battle, was we had a very bad run against his Snorlax, but we still came over in the second match and cleared off Kanto and Gym Leader Castle in its entirety. Overall difficulty was definitely noticeable. I'd say maybe a 5 out of 10, 5 to 6 out of 10, but it's still pretty doable. Then we had moved on to the stadiums. Little Cup was a little bit longer. I love the ending for Little Cup though. After our loss against the last trainer in Little Cup, we got a crit to end it off perfectly. That was a great way to end Little Cup. Moving on to Poke Cup, Pokeball and Great Ball weren't that bad. I think we still strolled pretty easily there. Ultra Ball was a little bit challenging. There was just a couple of unfortunate moments here and there. And then Master Ball was a little bit easier. The final battle. I liked the final battle. That was a great way to end the final battle against the Pokemaniac. And, Battle 7, though. Battle 7 took so many retries. That's the most we've ever had to have done in any kind of run. We had to retry that, like, 7-8 times just because of how bad I was being. And then we got a little bit lucky in the win that we had to do. Yeah, I do apologize for the bad quality. Yeah, sorry. And that was Poke Cup, was probably our most difficult. Then a close second was Challenge Cup. The first two... Pokeball for Challenge Cup was a little bit difficult just because we didn't have a great team. We still did okay. Great Ball was probably our most annoying. And then other than that, Ultra and Master were pretty good. We got good times on those, and for Master and Great Ball, the police officer was just a complete idiot. He was just throwing super hard. That's the definition of just throwing it out the window. But overall, Challenge Cup was our next difficult. Poke Cup would be first, and then Challenge by a very close hair. And then Prime Cup was unexpectedly one of the best. That I was expecting to be like an hour plus on that. That did not take that much at all. We did get lucky, though. We needed a lot of luck in that to get that kind of time, because that was even with my own team, the powerful, good pokes, too. And that was, we still needed a lot of good luck, because we got a lot of the statuses on our way, crits. Everything went good for us. Just one loss there with the Bird Boy. But that was still a good battle. So overall, the stadiums for round 2, definitely more difficult than round 1. But still, overall, a better experience. I would say in terms of difficulty, that was maybe like a 6 out of 10, 7 out of 10. It wasn't too terrible. And then the rival was perfect. perfect into the rival gloves for round one and round two. We did the strats that most people will typically do for the rival, and we did it successfully. Which brings us to here, the ending credits for the game. In a very bad sense of how the graphics are, I do apologize again. Don't have the most optimized build for these. I do apologize in advance if this is an occurring thing. But just to wrap up everything again, this has been a magnificent run. The journey of doing this game has given me a lot of joy, and I do want to thank you all for being a part of the journey. And for those who were introduced a little later, I still want to thank you immensely for being part of this journey too. It's just been amazing. This has been a game I've loved for the longest. I've played this not since it came out. I was still a little too young when this game came out. But around the time when I did purchase it, maybe 12 years ago, about 12, 13 years ago, I never completed it. I didn't even find out about the continue glitch up until maybe like 6 years ago, like definitely like way longer after I even purchased the original game. I never was able to complete it. I never had a Poke Transfer, the transfer pack that you would use on the 64 systems. I never had that. So I was basically using rentals the entire time. It didn't take until a couple years before this day when I did end up getting a transfer pack and then just transferred a bunch of my pokes from my original Pokemon Blue copy over to Stadium 2. I did complete round 1, but round 2 I never got the chance to complete it until about 4 or 5 years ago. That's when I first beat the game, the very first time I beat the game. And it made me so thrilled just playing the game. I played the original 2 Pokemon Stadium. I don't have a plan to do that run in the moment. It may come up. I'm not canceling it out completely. I still love the game. I just prefer 2 more because it is a bit more optimized. It is does correct a lot of the things that Stadium 1 was at fault for. Or Stadium 1 in, of course, Pokemon Stadium, the one that's for North America at least. Did correct some things there that I didn't really like over there. But that's why I just prefer Stadium 2 more. It's a more refined game, if that's the right way to put it. But, of course, doing it here and having this done on YouTube for you guys has been just something I love to do. And while it is sad to see it come to an end, it's been something I will keep saying it. It's just been magnificent to do and love deep down. And one last time, ends it here. I get a Pokemon present for completing the game. I got a Gligar that can learn Earthquake. Although we probably won't be even using it at all, so, yeah. Well, guys, you just witnessed it. You made it here. We made it to the end of Pokemon Stadium 2. We've done everything we can here. It has finally come to an end. And what I have to say to that is thank you very much for watching the entirety of the series, being a part of the journey, being a part of the ROM Boy Squad. I do appreciate every one of you that's been following, that's liked, that's left some comments, everything, as we see. I appreciate and give lots of love to everyone there that's been following me here on this journey. I do have to say with sadness that our journey does end here for Pokemon Stadium 2, but our walkthrough series is not done here. I do have other video games I do plan on doing in the future. Of course, watch out for those. I will keep in touch, of course, for those as well. And it's just been great. Another thing I will say on that is I still plan on playing Pokemon Stadium 2. Apart from, of course, adding onto the series playlist. I have thought about live streaming this game. I did want to, of course, do like some gym leader runs, some stadium runs, or if specifically just specific cup runs or any kind of runs like that live so you guys can join in. Of course, bringing along anybody that's part of the journey, that's part of the thrill. Haven't decided when I'm doing that, but I do plan on doing it. Of course, depending on feedback and what I'm feeling, honestly what I'm feeling, you guys will definitely know about that. But, of course, as of right now, the journey does end here. And I wanted to say again, big thank you again for all the support and for everyone that's been joining along with me since day one. So much love. Thank you so much again. So this has been my Pokemon Stadium 2 walkthrough series. It has now come to an end. Again, with much love, thank you. And I will see you guys in my next walkthrough. I'll just leave that as a surprise. I do have an idea of what I want to do next. But just like in the world of Pokemon and in life, there's always going to be surprises. So watch out for my next one. Until then, take care, and I will see you next time. Bye.